with the local farm club subscription business. This one right here. So I grew up in a farming community, and I know that the American farmer for most of my growing up years was a dying breed. And I think luckily there's been some awareness to that, and it's kind of brought some of the farmers back from the brink. But so for those farmers coming back from the brink, specifically the smaller farms, this thing right here is just giant. It's able to set up an infrastructure for you to get your products, whether it's milk or whether it is eggs or whether it's corn or whatever it is, into the hands of consumers in your region, in your area, in a really efficient way, and just get you set up with the infrastructure to do what you need to do to keep your farm alive, sell your products.
Absolutely. And I think it's coming at exactly the right time because, you know, I think the demand for farm fresh goods has never been higher. You know, people are aware of all the benefits of getting artisan goods from their local farms. And, you know, this is something that can, you know, stimulate the local economy. This is something that gets the farmer and the farm owner connected with the customer base that normally they're separated from via intermediary channels that they have Absolutely. To pay additional overhead on and things like that. So this, I think, gives a unique opportunity to a farm operator to generate, you know, high profit in direct produced goods and establish direct customer relationships, maybe even, you know, create a brand around that, which could be profitable for years to come.
Yeah. Well, and I know too, you know, I go to the grocery store and every once in a while I'll see farm fresh eggs or something that's not just the cage free, but, and there's more of an awareness going on about that too. Like I used to raise chickens. I've had hundreds of chickens at one point in time in my life, but the cage free means that, it could mean they're in a building where they never see the sunlight. And so the eggs that I buy are more expensive than the cage-free eggs, but they taste better. These are chickens that are out eating bugs. And I'm not the only one that's more aware of this. There's a building awareness. And I think a lot of it is just due to how we're connected here in the 21st century. We've got YouTube, we've got, you know, social media, we've got all these things that make us more aware as consumers of not only what we're eating, number one, but number two, the quality of the food that's out there. Like, you know, you think that the cage-free eggs taste good? My gosh, try a free-range egg where these chickens have access to eat bugs and other natural sources of protein. The egg yolk is more yellow. It tastes better. It's better for you. I mean, just the quality difference is huge. And people pay more for that. And so, you know, but my point is going back to the grocery store. So, you know, I have this certain type of eggs that I buy every single time, but I'll see these gallons of milk from a local farm in a glass bottle or something like that. And every once in a while I buy them, but I don't have a name associated with that. I don't know that I'm supporting Bill and Jane with my purchase. So if I knew that, I can tell you for certain that would be, I would probably switch my milk purchasing from the grocery store to exclusively, because I mean, I'm going to buy milk anyway, right? So even if Bill and Jane can get kind of sort of similarly close to what I'm already going to be paying anyway, and I know that I'm supporting them and I'm supporting their farm, I've seen pictures on how they take care of their cows, or I've seen pictures of the field where the corn comes from. These type of things, these personal connections, make it a whole lot harder to stop doing business with that business down the road because you know the family that you're supporting with your purchase.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think the rise of farm brands is definitely a thing. And I think that, you know, it also creates an established product type against the brand. You know, that's what your milk and your eggs taste like. And I think that that's going to, like you said, drive consumer consistency so that you're seeing that, you know, weekly return of reordered goods. But the other thing that I think would be, you know, an interesting consideration is that by knowing this comes from a, you know, local farm geographically near you, it's also going to be more environmentally friendly. So you're not, absolutely, you know, having the impact to the environment that you might have with another quote unquote local product that the, you know, regional grocery store is selling, but maybe was sourced 3 or 4 states away.
Right.
So I think there's an added benefit there as well.
No, I totally agree with that. Now, you've worked under our business methodology. Tell me how our way of doing things has impacted your life.
Well, it's improved my life in many different ways. I've learned to, you know, operate in business more efficiently, more strategically, with a greater focus on win-win outcomes, you know, where the business is profiting, but the, you know, clients and customers are happy. So it's been a very enriching process, and I've learned a lot from you guys. You guys have that entrepreneurial spirit that just makes for good business. And so it's been just an absolute pleasure working with you guys.
And now, what about financially? How would you say your situation is different?
Well, it's been enormously personally rewarding, you know, financially rewarding. We've been able to do things we never imagined being able to do just a few years before. You know, your unique approach to business has enabled us to, you know, be more profitable than our competitors. We've had a better work-life balance, I think, than most people who, you know, even get close to approaching our income threshold. So I think really, I mean, as rewarding as something could be, you know, it has been for us.
Now, do you feel like our way of doing things has profitability advantages over traditional ways of doing business?
Oh, most certainly. Yeah. I think you can, you know, tell just by our history of growth. I mean, we, I think, are willing to adapt our business strategies, fill any niche role that's out there, and just, you know, capitalize on things that other businesses aren't even aware of. So, yeah, I think we, you know, have had a much greater level of success than our competitors with more profitability and oftentimes less busy work.
Yeah, certainly. And I think, too, you know, with the Startup Series goes over all sorts of that kind of stuff. And you know, just the ways that we've been luckily forced to adapt and learn how to do things with less staff and, you know, more technology based or more efficiency based, is really picking things apart down to the typing of emails or not. Stuff like that makes a huge difference, I think.
Absolutely. Yeah. Breaking things down to their kind of constituent components, seeing what you absolutely have to have, what's not necessary, and then putting your energy behind what drives, you know, maximum productivity and profitability. And I think that's been where we've had a lot of our success.
Now, Justin, what would you say to someone who is thinking about buying one of these business packages, but is maybe nervous about starting a business from scratch instead of going with a more expensive traditional franchise, or, you know, maybe nervous about something else with starting a business?
Well, I would say that, you know, now is a very good time, I think, for someone to look at starting their own business. And I think, you know, when you're weighing these options, say in comparison to a more expensive franchise, I think the flexibility that's afforded because you still own and have control of your own business, I think that's huge. I think that's why a lot of people start a business. You know, they don't want to have to report to someone and curtail their goal and operations based on the direction of somebody else. So I think you get all of those benefits. But I think the other thing that's, you know, a major advantage is that it is lower cost. You're not paying a percentage of your income for an indefinite period. You just have the ability to take a proven model, to adapt it to your specific situation, to be given all the tools to implement your strategy and your goals and to achieve it. And I think that's huge.
Yeah. And I would agree with that. I mean, as an entrepreneur myself, obviously, that started several businesses, you know, when I look back over what worked really well and what did not work really well, it's the unknowns that are waiting out there to just, you know, grab you by the foot and trip you up. And that's really what I think makes businesses fail. I think that there's probably two major things that make businesses fail. Number one is not knowing a system and process that's proven for success, which it takes a while to get there. And then number two is just these pitfalls that every single entrepreneur will face at some point in time or another. And having the Startup Series as a guide to continually reference back to me, makes all the difference in the world compared to somebody that does not have that resource. And business consultants are really, really, really expensive. It's a good way to, you know, especially when you're in the startup phases, that's a good way to really drain profitability, is having to call somebody and pay them by the hour every time you have a question, rather than just referencing a resource that you've got on your computer.
Definitely. Yeah. I mean, you're getting basically a veteran business model that works.
Yeah.
And you're able to use that from the get-go. So, I mean, it's like, you know, taking the Microsoft model when you're starting a software company. It's as good a start as you could have.
Well, Justin, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate you joining me here and going over these business packages. And, you know, for you guys there thinking about this, you can submit on our website or you can give us a call at 844-500-6620 and speak with a business launching consultant. Again, that's 844-500-6620. Thanks so much.